In this program, we're going to see the magic of using XSLT to transform your XML documents into various formats. XSLT stands for Extensible Style Sheet Language Transformation. Extensible Style Sheet is a styling language for XML. W3 Consortium started to develop XSL because there was a need for an XML-based style sheet language. HTML uses predefined tags and tells how to display each tag, and CSS is used to add styles to the HTML elements. Whereas XML does not use predefined tags and therefore the meaning of each tag is not well understood. So XSL describes how the XML element should be displayed. XSLT is basically a programming language mixed with little XHTML and some CSS. And we will feed this into a parser, and now the parser can either be Internet Explorer, Firefox, or can use more professional parser like Saxon. And this parser will combine the XSLT statement and XML data and come out with a new output. This output can be XHTML, a PDF file, a zip file, or just a plain text, or with XSLT statements. You can completely reformat your XML and come up with a different structure or a different format for an XML document. And this is commonly used to transform an XML document from one structure to another, like two companies that have two different structures but similar data. So let's start out by opening up the two files. We are going to look at the student.xml as well as student.sxl, and the file will end up with student.html. We create an XML file that contains information about four students, and we display this XML file using XSLT. For that, we link the student.xml file with student.xsl that contains the corresponding XSL style sheet rules. You can view these in TextPad, Notepad, or any other editor that you would like to use. Open up student.xml and student.xsl. Let's take a quick look at student.xml file. In line 1, you will see a regular XML declarations. And in line 2, we will put in our connection that will connect our XSLT file. And this is type of the style sheet as text slash XSL. And version 2.0, which works well with Saxon processor. And here is where we connect with the actual physical file. So we'll be connecting with student.xsl. The root element is student, and it is made up of several person elements. And here you can see the person element for RS, and here is one for Bismi, and of course for show, and on and on. And the objective here is to show each of these peoples on a separate line of a table on a web page. So we are going to show the RS data across a row and Bismi's data across a row and so on. And we are going to use the XSLT to do that. Now let's take a look at the XSLT document. At the very top, you will see the XML declaration. And that tells you that XSLT is a XML document. And we have style sheet. And this is where we set up the namespace for the document. Notice we are using version 2.0. And this is useful in current version of Saxon. I have added a code template match, which matches our root. And down in the bottom of the document, you can see the stop tag for template element. And here is the stop tag for style sheet that matches the root element at the top of the document. So probably now you'll know what you will be doing. So let's get to work. First, connect your XML document to your XSLT. We are telling the parser that this is going to be an XSL connection. We are setting the version and the file name student.xsl. Now open up the XSL document, that is student.xsl, and add the namespace. And the namespace is used to identify the XSL processing statements. And don't forget to add the XSL style sheet at the end of the document. And here we use the namespace to call out the XSL template element. And here we are going into the series of XHTML elements. An XSL style sheet consists of one or more set of rules that are called templates. XSL template defines a way to reuse the templates in order to get the desired output for the node of a particular type or content. The XSL template element is used to build templates. This element must have either match attribute or name attribute set. The match attribute indicates on which path the template transformation is going to be applied. The match attribute is used to associate a template with the XML element, and this attribute can also be used to define the template for the entire XML document. And if the value of the match attribute is XPath expression, that is the match equals forward slash, it defines the whole document. The content inside the XSL template element defines some HTML to write to the output. The last two lines defines the end of the template and the end of the style sheet. XSL for each element allows you to do looping in XSLT, and this element can be used to select every XML element of specified node set. That is, this element is used to apply the template repeatedly for each nodes. So this will iterate over XML nodes as defined by the expression in a select attribute. The expression defined in the select attribute is either XPath expression or a variable reference pointing to a node set in a source document. We can also filter the output from the XML file by adding the criterion to the select attribute in the XSL for each element. And it can be done using the legal filter operators like equal to, not equal to, less than or greater than. XSL sort element is used to sort the output. To sort the output, simply add XSL sort element inside the XSL for each element in the XSL file. And here the select attribute indicates which XML elements to sort on. The XSL value of element is used to extract the value of XML element and add it to the output stream of the transformation. Now run the file. Select the XML document. You can see the formatted XML document with XSL statements applied to it. The student's data given are displayed as a table. As I mentioned earlier, the match attribute indicates on which parts the template transformation is going to be applied. In this particular case, the slash means it is applied to the root of the XML document. That is, this element will be applied for the whole document. So the table will possess the property of border 5 with cell padding 20 and it is center aligned. This line of code is applied to the top row of the table. The for each element selects all the student details. And this color is set as a background color for the entire table rows. The value of element extracts all the values under the select attribute. Finally, the sort element. The sort element is used to sort the output. The select attribute indicates what XML elements to sort on. The value of the select attribute given here is percentage. And this is the result we get from the defined style sheet after sorting. Here the percentage is magically reordered with XSLT. Thank you guys, see you next video.